بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين جل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف وجعلنا من أعوانه وأنصاره اللهم أخرجني من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمني بنور الفهم اللهم افتح علينا أبواب رحمتك وانشر علينا خزائن علمك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. This is inshallah our last session in 2016 on Usul. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the sessions we have had so far. And we ask him to, inshallah, bless us by being able to continue. If you enjoyed Usul, then you can say Ameen. Okay. You remember we said there are two points at the end of the discussion about Mafhoom al-Shart. The first was, إِذَا تَعَدَّدَ الشَّارْطَ وَاتَّحَدَ الْجَزَاءَ. When there are two conditions, but one conditional, one jaza. And we said, initially there is a conflict. If we believe in mafhum for jumla shartiyya, there is a conflict between manduq of one and the mafhum of the other, between a spoken meaning of one and implicit meaning of the other. Because mafhum of each of them is that if this condition does not happen, that conditional does not happen. But the other one says there is another condition that if that too happens, the conditional happens. So there is a conflict at the beginning. But then we said this can be sorted out by one of the two solutions. Either we say the real condition was not each of these two independently. Rather, the real condition was these two combined. When both of them happen, jaza happened. For example, إِذَا خَفِيَ الْعَذَانِ فَقَصَّرْ. Can I tell you a secret? Mm-hmm. One of the exam questions is about mafhum al-shart. Okay. It's a secret and it's recorded. Okay. But you know, mafhum al-shart was for 3-4 sessions. So in this way, I am encouraging you to study more mafhum al-shart. Okay. You didn't hear anything, huh? Okay. Okay.
How many exam questions would they be?
Pardon?
How many exam questions?
This is too secretive. Okay. So, إِذَا خَفِيَ الْأَذَانِ فَقَصِّرْ. If azan is hidden, make your salat qasr. إِذَا خَفِيَ الْجُدْرَانِ فَقَصِّرْ. If walls are hidden, make your salat qasr. So, one solution is to say, because Shara would not contradict himself, it means when both of them happen together and are combined. إِذَا خَفِيَ الْأَذَانُ وَالْجُدْرَانُ مَعًا فَقَصَّرْ. When both of them happen, and the result is that, you know, the mafhum for this then would be if none of them happens, or if one of them happens, still you don't do qasr. Yeah? Because when you have A plus B, then opposite to this is either there is no A or there is no B or there is none. Is it clear? You know, is it clear? When you want to have a combination, it means that they all must exist together. When you say all of them do not exist, means either none of them exist or some of them exist. So this is one solution to say it means we have to have both of them together. So if both are not there, Salat is complete, even if one of them is there. The other solution is to say it meant either this or that as alternative conditions. When you put them together, it means إذا خفي الأذان or إذا خفي الجدران فقصر. Okay? When the first happens or the second happens, one of them is enough. So for you not to make قصر, then none of them should happen. You understand? The difference is clear. According to the first, even if one of them happens, you still do kamel, not qasr. But according to second, if one happens, is qasr. If none, then it is tam. Okay, so we have discussed this much. On Monday, alhamdulillah, we discussed this much. Yes. Inhisar means that's the only condition, the only cause, which is in Jumla Shartiyya. Means there is no alternative. So either the Inhisar has to be removed or Istiqlal. Istiqlal means to be independent, is removed when you combine them. Inhisar is removed when you say either this or this. There are two ways, as I said. Okay, now question, which of these two solutions should be followed? Which of these two solutions? It's not in our hand to decide and say, for example, I want to treat this Jumla-i Shartiyya by combining conditions, another one by, you know, making them alternative. It's not up to us. Yeah, we have to find an some evidence either in that sentence or generally. So Ayatullah Subhani says illa annahu, page 100, last paragraph. Okay, so it's very important page 100. Yeah, so now you are moving to another 100 pages. إِلَّا أَنَّهُ وَقَعَ الْكَلَامُ فِي تَقْدِيمِ أَحَدِ التَّصَرُّفَيْنِ عَلَى الْآخَرِ. The discussion has now become which one should be preferred, which of these two treatments, combining or taking them as alternative. وَالظَّاهِرِ, he says, it seems that التَّصَرُّف فِي ظُهُورِ كُلٍ مِنَ الشَّرْطَيْنِ فِي الْإِنْحِصَارِ. He says, it seems that to compromise about exclusiveness proceeds. So we give preference to this compromise. It's easier. You need less intervention. Please remember, whenever intervention is needed, do the least of intervention. Is it clear?
One should be enough.
Yeah. But even among these two, one requires more intervention. One is more difficult. One takes more energy. So, between removing Inhisar or removing Istiqlal, Inhisar is easier to compromise than Istiqlal. So, Inhisar means that there is only one condition, for example, only one condition for praying, qasr. Istiqlal means whatever we said was enough. There is nothing to be added to it. Inhisar means there is no alternative. Istighlal means nothing to be added. Okay? So,
is this a principle?
Pardon?
Is this a principle for all cases?
Here, in Jumlah Shartiyah, yes, for all Jumlah Shartiyah, yes, for all Jumlah Shartiyah. الظاهر هو التصرف في ظهور كل من الشرطين في الانحصار فيكون كل منهما مستقلا في التأثير. So both of them remain independent. So each of them is independent cause. You know, because if you look at your common sense, okay? If you look at common sense, when two jumlah shartiyah are said, the first thing that comes to mind is that each of them is enough. If this happens, jaza happens. If the other, but to say that no, this means that they have to be combined. This needs kind of intervention, because if they were supposed to be combined, why they were said in this way? Why they were not said together? Yeah, it's much more easier to think that because someone had asked about, for example, not hearing azan, so that was said. Another case, someone was about not seeing Jodran, that was said. But if both of them are needed, why Imam alayhi salam, for example, or Prophet only mentioned one? He should have said everything needed. So to remove our hand from istiqlal is more difficult than from inhisar. Okay? For example, let me give an example. Inshallah, this example will make it very easy. Inshallah. One day, I tell you, for usul, if you make mubahasa and give me report of mubahasa, I give you 4 marks out of 20. 4. Another day, I say, if you give me a summary of what we discussed in the semester, I give you 4 marks. When you hear these two, you wonder, Sheikh Shumali forgets what he says, or no, he doesn't forget. So you say, inshallah, that no, Sheikh Shumali seems doesn't forget, so he doesn't contradict himself, so he meant both. Okay, now, if he meant both, what did he mean? Did he mean that if we give report of mubahasa and give him the summary, both of them, he gives us 4 marks? Or if we give each, he gives us 4 marks? Which one is more natural? If your teacher says, if you do this, I give you 4 marks. If you do this, I give you 4 marks. Which one is common sense understanding?
Either
means either this or that. Not that if you do them together. If I meant you have to do them together, why I didn't say to you have to do them together? Pardon? Uh-huh. Then that's another issue. This is actually the next point that we want to make. So the first is that each of them, if happens, you get 4 marks. Now the question is, this says by giving report of mubahasa, you get 4 marks. This says by doing giving a summary, you get 4 marks. And each of them is working. Now the question is, can Sheikh Shomali just give 4 marks to those who have given both? This is called tadakhulul musabbabat. Tadakhulul musabbabat. Tadakhul. Can I give you four? And if you tell me, Sheikh, you told me give four for Mubahisa. I said, I gave you. He said, you told us we give four for summary. I said, yes, I gave you. Is it possible or I have to give you four for each? This is the next point, inshallah, we discuss. Yes. So the first issue become easy, yeah? Does it mean that you have to give both combined or each is enough? As you understood, common sense understanding is that unless there is evidence to suggest otherwise, we take it as alternative. Each of them is enough. Is it clear? Pardon?
Either of them.
Yes, either is enough. Okay.
One or one.
Yes. You have question?
Me?
Huh?
Yes, I'm asking
you. Okay, please.
I'm asking you, so based on this example, do we take the first dimension here and then do we take that one? Is that half year to or is that half year to draw?
So we say Inhisar is removed, so it means either this or that. فَيَكُونُ كُلٌ مِنْهُمَا مُسْتَقِلًا فِي تَأْسِيرٍ. Each of them is independently working. Each of them is enough. فَإِذَا فَرَدَ أَحَدُهُمَا كَانَ لَهُ التَّأْثِيرُ فِي سُبُوتِ الْحُكْمِ. If one of them is there, it can bring the... Yes, the same effect. وَإِذَا حَصَلَ مَعَنْ. And if both of them happen, فَإِنْ كَانَ حُصُولُهُمَا بِالتَّعَاقُبِ. For example, if for you have the, you know, you have reached the point that you don't hear Azan and you don't see the walls. You have reached the point that both of them are applicable. You say, okay, the first one was enough. And here it is clear that when one of them works and so Salat becomes Qasr, then the other one is not going to make it more Qasr. No. Yeah. Here there is no possibility of thinking that should I make it more Qasr? Pardon?
Double.
Or double Qasr? No. So the first one is enough and the other one is somehow not relevant, not, you know, I don't want to say useless, but maybe I can say useless, I don't know, think about it. Anyway, the first one is working, the second is not working. But if both of them happen at the same time, then we can say both of them together cause this. Yeah, it's not a big deal. Anyway, one of them is enough. Is it clear? فَإِنْ كَانَ حُصُولُهُمَا بِالتَّعَاقُبِ. If they happened one after the other, تَعَاقُب comes from إِقَاب. It means one after the other. فَإِنْ كَانَ حُصُولُهُمَا بِالتَّعَاقُبِ كَانَ تَأْثِيرُ لِلسَّابِقِ. The one who is first, the one who precedes, that is the one who has effect. وَإِنْ تَقَارَنَا. But if they both come together, كَانَ الْأَثَرُ لَهُمَا مَعًا. Both of them have this effect, and both of them together are like sabab. There is no reason to fight about, you know, who, you know. No, they didn't come first. So there is no point to talk, you know, which one, you know, had the effect. Is it clear? Why you said, you may ask Ayatollah Subhani, why you said the first intervention about Inhisar is preferred? Why? Of course, I explained you, but in the text also need explanation. إِنَّمَا قُلْنَا بِرُجْهَانِ التَّصَرُّفِ فِي الْإِنْحِسَارِ عَلَى التَّصَرُّفِ فِي السَّبَبِيَّةِ التَّامَّةِ. We said to do intervention with respect to Inhisar is preferred over intervention with respect to complete causality, independence. Why? لأجل أن التصرف في الانحصار مما لابد منه. Because this intervention is the least. Because you have to do it anyway. You have to do this tasarruf anyway. سواء تعلق التصرف برفع الانحصار أو تعلق التصرف برفع السببية التامة. Because whether you say that there was no exclusiveness or you say there was no independence, at least you have to accept that it's not just one of them alone that works. Definitely this is wrong. If someone says it's only a matter of azan, nothing else, this is wrong. So you have to compromise about this. So if we want to keep the intervention to the least and to the minimum, we say, okay, it's either. فالانحصاريو انحصارو قطعی الزوال و متيقن الارتفاع. So exclusiveness definitely is removed, is gone. There is no doubt about it. قطعی الزوال, زوال, ارتفاع is the same. It's definitely gone. But independent causality, unknown, dubious. So why we should then remove it? When something you know has gone and the other one you don't know, okay, keep it to the minimum. Yeah? Keep it to the minimum. Is it clear? When you remove enhesar, yes. But then there will be mafhum for that complete. That can be, you say, it still has mafhum. You may say, you know, that if, because for example, it says, اَذَا خَفِيَ الْأَذَانَ اَوَلْ جُدْرَانَ. If you accept mafhum, then mafhum would be when none of them happens, there is no qasr. The second point, which is the last point for today, for this week, for this month, and for this year, and this semester, okay? It's the last point. التنبيه الثاني في تداخل الأسباب والمسببات. It's about, give me a good term. You know, when two things get together or, you know, enter each other, like a kind of combination, but it's not combination. Pardon?
Supplement each other?
No, no. Can we say submerge?
One is bigger than the other
one. No, no. It's not, the size is not important. Just two things.
Elaborate.
No, no, no. You know, when, for example, two co's, they submerge, means one of them can work. Submerge, I think, is good. Yeah. For the time being, think of...
Intermingle
is good, but not... it doesn't intermingle very good with the text. Submerge.
Just merge.
Just merge. Uh-huh. Yes. Let me give you an example.
Merge is better.
Pardon?
Merge is better.
Okay. If, for example, if we say about like ghusl, for example, if someone is junub, has to make ghusl. If, for example, it's Jum'ah, again, you want to do ghusl. Of course, it's mustahab, but you want to do ghusl. Or someone has made nazr that on Jum'ah, he makes ghusl Jum'ah. Becomes wajib for him. Okay? So, now, if he is both Junub and it is Jum'ah, So does he need to make two ghusl, or one ghusl is enough?
One ghusl is enough. We've done this before. You've answered this before in the previous classes. One ghusl is sufficient.
According to some views, one ghusl is enough. But maybe some people say, no, we have to have two ghusl, because each of them is separate. So this is the issue of tadakhul. Tadakhul al-asbab means one of the causes work. Tadakhul al-musabbabat means you have two independent causes, but musabbab, the one which is caused, would merge. Merge, combine. Think about it, maybe you come up. What is in the translation? Pardon? Yeah, so it's not
merge
is good, yeah? Merge. Combine is good, but not is not very, I don't want to say it's not accurate, you know, it's not giving you the same. Yes, doesn't convey the same. Doesn't combine well. Okay. Eza ta'addad as-sabab wa ittahad al-jaza. When we have two sabab, you know, two cause, and the same jaza, but there can be one of the two causes. For example, Eza bulta fatawadda. If you go to washroom, make wuzu. Of course, you mean what I mean. Not that everyone goes to washroom. Okay. Wa iza numta fatawazza. And when you sleep, make wuzu. Okay. So yaga'u al-kalam fi tadakhul al-asbab. Awwalan. Then there are two things to discuss here. Does bowl and nome, you know, going to washroom and sleeping, do they merge or not? And then if we say they don't merge and each of them is a cause, independent cause, then do the musabbabs, I mean wuzu for this and wuzu for this, merge so that I make just one wuzu, or I have to make two wuzu. Al murad min tadakhul al asbab wa adamihi huwa anna sababain. What we mean by merging of causes is that are these two causes implying one wujub, so that actually it's like one of them was there. Although now you have made a bowl and you have a slab, but it's like one of them. Tadakhal al asbab fi ta'sir means they merge and they do just one thing. Or yaqtaziyan wujuban, they don't merge. Each of them is working. Is it clear? Fala tatadakhal fi maqam ta'sir. Imagine, I give you an example. For example, if I switch on a light here, it gives you some light, certain amount of light. I can have an equal light and I can switch off this and switch on that. This also gives me the same amount of light. Okay. Now, if I switch on both, what happens? then you would have doubled the light. Okay, you have doubled the light. This means that there has been no merging. Each of them has worked separately. But imagine if we have an automatic system here that when one is switched on, gives independently that light, and when both are switched on, they produce 50%, for example, of the light. So all together, they give the same amount of light. When this is like this, it's tadakhul. Or when I switch on both, one of them only works and gives me 100%. Again, this is tadakhul. It's a kind of cooperation, a kind of, you know, merging. Okay? So this is the difference. أما المراد من تداخل المسببات. What we mean by merging of مسبب, what is caused, the effect, is that أسباب are not merging. We cannot solve the problem by أسباب, saying that أسباب have merged. Can مسبب merge؟ أن الاتيان بالطبيعة مرة. To do that thing, bring an instance of that mahiyya. Tabi'a here is mahiyya, quiddity, nature. If I bring an instance, is it enough? Or I have to bring two instances? For example, you told me make wuzu. Okay, wuzu happens by one wuzu. Is it enough or I have to make two wuzu? Okay? هل يكفي في امتثال كلا الوجوبين او يتوقف على الاتيان بها means بالطبيعة مرتين. I have to bring that mahiyya twice into existence. Okay, this discussion depends on accepting two things. If you want to say whether مسببات merge or not, you have to accept two things. First is that asbab have not merged. Because if asbab have merged, then we don't need to talk about musabbab. The problem is solved already. If asbab have merged, we have like one sabab. So we don't need to talk about it. But suppose asbab have not merged. Each of them is independent. اولا عدم التداخل في الاسباب والا فلا وجه للبحث عن التداخل في المسببات لافتراض وحدة السبب لأجل التداخل. Because if سبب is the same out of merging, we don't need to talk about مسببات. Don't need to bother about مسببات. Second, again, the second condition for what? The second condition for relevance of this discussion. You know, when you are talking about تداخل المسببات, first, if you didn't accept tadakhul al-asbab. Second, if there is a case that it makes sense to say, should I do it twice or not? إذا أمكن تكرار الجزاء, when it was possible to do twice, three times, for example. كالوزو. Wuzu is something that you can do it twice. But if جزاء was something that is not possible to repeat. For example, the judge is going to make a sentence about life of someone. Because this person, for example, has committed two crimes that each of them was leading to death sentence. If the judge wants to use the legal text and say, okay, according to this, you know, sentence, he has committed this crime and he's going to be sentenced. According to this, he has to, but how many times a person can be sentenced to death or can be killed? Doesn't make sense to say you have to repeat. Okay? It doesn't make sense. Okay. إذا أمكن تكرار الجزاء when it's possible to repeat like وضوء otherwise يسقط البحث بحث drops كما إذا قال من ارتد عن دينه فاقتله وإذا كان الكافر محاربا فاقتله and different things that you understood بحث means discussion بحث is discussion إذا No. Sabab is breaking wuzu. Musabab is wujub wuzu. When wuzu is wajib, musabab means caused. What is the cause? What is sabab? Those things that break wuzu. Yes. Okay. Now, after you understood, inshallah, what is the issue? You understood? Tadakhul al-aswab, tadakhul. You made a kind of conception, yeah? You conceived this. Okay, now. يَغَعُ الْكَلَامِ فِي مَوْزَئِن We have to discuss about two issues. الأول حُكْمُ الْأَسْبَابِ مِنْ حَيْثُ التَّدَاخُلِ وَأَدَمِ So first, let us discuss whether asbab can merge or not. Because if we answer this positively, we don't need to then discuss the second one. If asbab merge, then you don't need to worry about tekrar of musabbabat.
Causes.
Okay? So first we talk about asbab. If asbab do not merge, then we talk about whether musabbabat merge or not. Is it clear? حكم الأسباب من حيث التداخل وعدمه. This is the first issue. الأول. المتبادر عرفا. What comes to mind in common sense discussion is this. That when you hear, when you make bowl, urine comes out, make wuzu. When you sleep, make wuzu. What comes to common sense quickly is they don't merge.
They don't merge.
Means each of them is a cause. So either the other one exists or doesn't exist, each of them is working. وَلَيْسَ لَعَدَمِ تَدَاخُلِ الْأَسْبَابِ فِي مَقَامِ التَّأْسِيرِ When we say each of them works, it means that each of them is enough to ask for wuzu, demand wuzu. So the first assumption is not تَدَاخُلُ الْأَسْبَابِ It's very difficult to say asbab merge. So we have to go now to the second stage and say, okay, each of them is working. Each of them demands wuzu. Now, can we make one wuzu or we have to make two wuzu? حكم تداخل المسببات أي كفاية وضوء واحد وعدم عدم it means عدم كفاية wuzu is not enough one wuzu الظاهر or we can say وعدم he means عدم تداخل كفاية وضوء واحد وعدمه if it was عدمها was maybe better you know means it's not enough to have one وضوء but if it is عدمه we have to say تداخل الظاهر عدم ظهور القضية في أحد الطرفين آيت الله سبحانه says it seems that really we don't understand from the text here we have to suspend our judgment there is no enough of ظهور to suggest whether they merge or they don't merge. So when you cannot understand something from the text and you have still to do something, what do you do? We said, usul amaliyah. When you have don't have any guidance to tell you what is hukm awwaliyah waqi'i, then you go for hukm Amali through the usul amaliyah. So, فتصل النوبة إلى الأصل العملي. So it comes to أصل عملي. وهو أن الأصل عدم سقوط الواجبات المتعددة بفعل واحد. أصل is this. The first assumption. The first assumption is what? Do you remember, I think we had this exam also, if I'm not mistaken, in previous book. When I asked you to mention four usul amaliye and in a way which is, you know, why it cannot be more. We had this in exam, yeah? So, not only I gave you exam of this, you know, semester question, I am also mentioning a question of last semester. But it's too late. So, but maybe even last year I told you that this can be asked in the, yeah? I think I said this will be asked in the exam. Pardon? Yeah. So, if you remember, we said, anyone remembers how to prove that there are only four? We said, either you know there has been taklif or no. If you don't know, bara'ah, exemption. Because as long as you are not certain that any obligation has belonged to you, you can do bara'ah. If you know there has been taklif, but you don't know how you should do it, okay? Then if there is possibility of doing ihtiyat, you have to do ihtiyat. If it's not possible to do ihtiyat, then you have choice. And all these three is when the previous condition is not known. If the previous condition is known, then you go for istishab. Okay? So either you know the previous condition or you don't know. If you know the previous condition for sure, and you doubt whether it is remaining or not, istishab. If you don't know the previous condition, and you don't know whether there has been taklif, bara'ah. You know there has been taklif, then do you know whether ihtiyat is possible or not? If ihtiyat possible, ihtiyat. Why ihtiyat? Because when I know an obligation has belonged to me, and I don't know by doing this, I am able to fulfill the requirement of ubudiyya, or I have to do something more or another thing, then you have to do ihtiyat. For example, you know that you have to say tasbihat in third rak'ah. And imagine you don't know, is it one or three? Imagine. You don't know. So you have to do three. Yeah? You don't know in the time of ghaibah, you have to do salatul jummah or salatul dhuhr. Suppose you don't know, faqih doesn't know, okay, has to do both. You know you have to say salat, but you don't know whether your salat is qasr or tamam. You have to do both. You know that you have to do salat, but you don't know qibla. You have to do four. Why? Because al-ishtighal al-yaqini yastad'i al-faragh al-yaqini. When you know your dhimma, I don't know if it makes sense to say in English, your neck. Yeah, I know responded. No, I mean, because in Arabic, it comes from like, you know, you say, you know, there is something on your neck, on your shoulder.
Yoke.
On yoke?
Yoke.
Yes, no, I mean, they use it for responsibility. Okay. So they say there's a responsibility on your yoke?
There's a yoke.
There's a yoke on you. Okay, so when there is a yoke on you or you have a responsibility and you don't know whether by doing something you have fulfilled or not, you have to do ihtiyat. Is it clear? I gave you many examples. Make salat for four direction. Qas and itmam, zuhr and jum'ah, one or three tasbihat, three. All these examples show that if you are sure that there is taklif, but you don't know whether this is good answer or this, you have to do both. Yes.
The first one, you know that you I was just supposed to say, you know, you don't know.
No, that's...
You don't know, you don't know. And then...
No. We say, either you know the previous condition, or you don't know. Not just you know and you don't know. Either you know the previous condition, or you don't know. If you don't know the previous condition, and then you don't know that there is taklif, then bara. If you don't know the previous condition, but you know that there is taklif, then another question comes. Whether you can do ihtiyat or not. And if you know the previous condition, istisal. It's something that you must remember. This is one of the things that you have to remember always. It's easy, inshallah. If you understand the logic of it. Yeah? The logic, many things. You know, language is different, of course. Language, almost you have to memorize most of the thing, if not all. There is not that much logic in language. There is logic, but in very, maybe little. And this is why we say it's sam'i. Means you have to hear, you know. You cannot, you know, sit at home and learn a language without listening to the people and learning from the people. You know, think at home and, you know, through logic understand how to speak French. You have to learn from French speaking people. You cannot just sit at home and, you know, philosophize languages. Is it clear? But usul, philosophy, even akhlaq, many times it's a matter of understanding the reasoning behind them. If you understand the reasoning behind them, then you yourself can understand, and inshallah, then you can remember. Okay? You don't just memorize. You have to memorize, but through memorization, you have to learn how to come to the same conclusions yourself. Okay? Don't just store the information in your mind. Try to own it by understanding and reproducing. You have to reproduce it for yourself. First, you try to reproduce by producing what is in the market. Okay? So what other thinkers have said. But after 20 years, 30 years, when you are used to reproducing, then inshallah, then you can reproduce new things. But if you just memorize, you always become dependent, and even those things that you have memorized will be forgotten. Is it clear? So, حُكْمُ تَدَاخُلِ الْمُسَبَّبَاتِ. And we said here we should have to refer to usul amaliyah and al-asl. The practical principle here is that these different obligations would not drop by doing one. Even if you want to say, my niyya is that I want to do it for the sake of all those asbab. Your niyya is not sufficient here unless we have a reason. There is a hadith, for example, that says doing one ghusl for different causes is enough. You need to have extra evidence. Na'am dalla dalil. It must be low dalla. Low dalla. If there is a reason, there is a proof that different ghusl will drop by doing ghusl janabat or ghusl bahid, Nawa bihi suqut al-jami'. Maybe just we keep it as it is. Sorry, I made a mistake. Maybe it's better to keep it like this. Naam dalla dalil. Yes, there is a dalil, there is a proof that it's enough. In this case, we know that it's enough. Okay? In this case, it's enough. دَلَّ الدَّلِيلِ عَلَى سُقُوتَ أَقْصَالٍ مُتَعَدَّدَ بِقُسْلِ الْجَنَابَةِ أَوْ بِقُسْلٍ وَاحِدٍ but provided that نَوَى بِهِ سُقُوتَ. When I was studying this also, first it came to my mind like that, but then I realized. But now, again, I made mistake. You know, teachers also can make mistake. Pardon? نَوَى means made نِيَة. Okay. دَلَّ الدَّلِيلِ I repeat it again. دل الدليل على سقوط أقصال متعددة بغسل الجنابة. We have reason. A hadith, for example. Because there is no ayah about this, so must be hadith. Or ijma, for example. But here we have hadith that if you do غسل الجنابة, other أقصال drop. Other ghusl drop. Okay? But it one has to be ghusl janaba. This is one dalil that we have. Or we have another dalil, which is risky, and this is why I was reading that sentence in that way as a condition, because this one I don't think everyone accepts. That bi ghuslin wahid aghsal, ghusl drop. We're doing one ghusl, but if you made the intention of jami'ah. So if you were not mindful that I am making this ghusl for all of them, then no. But if your intention was that I do one ghusl for all those sabab, then it's enough. Is it clear? فخرجنا بهذه النتيجة. So the conclusion is this: أن مقتضى الأصل العملي هو عدم سقوط الواجبات المتعددة. What the practical principle requires is that different واجبات would not drop. You cannot do it just once, unless it is proved otherwise. If you don't have extra evidence, you have to repeat. Okay?
You have to do two
wuzu.
If not, in the case about wuzu, when you said about intention of jami'ah.
No, but for wuzu, the ulama say it's okay. Because we know that it's enough, one wuzu is enough. For wuzu, it's one enough. Even for ghusl, definitely, if ghusl janaba is one of them and you can do is enough, according to maybe, I don't know exception, maybe there is exception, but as far as I know, maraja accept with ghusl janaba. But for example, if it is other than ghusl janaba, then the niyyah must be different. The niyyah, you know, to be jami, for example, whatever. You refer to Risala for the practical duties. Okay, let us give you one example. There are here four cases, but the time is over. Let us at least give you one of these examples. For example, a person has to give zakat. Okay, imagine you are a person that zakat has applied to him, belong to him. You have certain golden coin or silver coin or, you know, wheat, barley, you know, zakat applies to you. So you have to give zakat, for example, to poor people. Now you have someone under your nafaqah, under your care. For example, your child, maybe your parent, maybe your child, maybe your spouse is under your care. Okay? Wife is under the care of husband. Children, if parents are not able to look after themselves financially, they are under your care. Can you say, okay, I have to look after them financially? I have also to give this zakat to someone who is needy. So can you give your zakat to the people that are under your care? If we say it's possible to merge, we say yes. But normally they say no. These are the people that are anyway under your care. You have to give them from your own money, not from zakat. They don't merge here. Is it clear? You cannot, you know, spend your money for the people that you have to look after them anyway. Let me also read maybe the last one, because there are four, we have no time. But the last one also. If there is a well and the water in well has been affected by najasa, for example, the taste or the smell or the color has changed because of najasa. There was a discussion in the fiqh that, for example, you have to make water out, bring water out, nasah. You have to take water out so that then fresh water comes instead and becomes tahir. And there was a discussion, for example, that how much water for every type of najasa has to be taken out. Now, if there are more than one najasa here that has affected the water. So for example, just example, for one of them you have to take 20 containers of water outside. For another one, for example, 10. Now, should I take 30 or just I take the maximum? Again, this is tadakhul. The first assumption is that you have to take 30. Yeah? Unless then you are sure that no, 20 is enough, for example. Because this has been double, you know, affected. Did you understand the issue? Inshallah, is clear? Okay. So, alhamdulillah, we finished mafhum al-shart. And inshallah, bi-iznillah ta'ala, we start next semester with mafhum al-wasp. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.